said, don't pray, I will pray. They said, don't read the Bible, I will read the Bible. They said, don't go to a Bible believing church, that's exactly where I'm going. They say, don't mention the name of Jesus, I mentioned that name. And then they say, aha, we saw him, we saw him. And then they went to the king. They said, that man, be very careful what you do to a man of decision. Tonight, as you become a man of decision, and you become a woman of decision, no weapon that is fashioned against you shall prosper. Every mouth that is opened against you, you will condemn. It's the heritage of the righteous, and the righteousness of me, says the Lord. And then they caught Daniel. Oh, what a pity. Don't pity Daniel. He is an overcomer. Don't pity Daniel. He's more than a conqueror. Don't pity a man of decision. He's coming out. Because from decision, he'll come to deliverance. From decision, he'll come to dominion. Then they locked him up in the lion's den. And when the lions saw him, they thought he was their friend. And they spread themselves like a great carpet. And Daniel slept all through the night. And the king in his palace could not sleep. Early in the morning, he woke up. And then he came and he said, Daniel, servant of the living God, is the God whom you serve able to deliver you from the lions? And Daniel spoke out. You will speak out. And Daniel spoke out. My sister, it is your turn. My brother, it is your turn. I'm telling you, from today, you are an overcomer. From today, you're more than a conqueror. You will speak out the voice of victory, and the voice of joy, and the voice of power, and the voice of authority. And Daniel spoke out. He says, so king, live forever. That's what they tell them. He said, live forever. He said, my God, my God. It was a personal knowledge. My God, it was a personal experience. My God, it was a personal deliverance. My God has sent his angel. And they shot the lion's mouth. He shot 10 lions and then keep only one mouth open. All those lions in your life, they are shut up. All those sickness in your life, they are gone in Jesus' name. Every big problem, every little problem, every Monday problem, tonight is your night. Man of decision, woman of decision, they are solved in Jesus' name. No paw of the lion will scratch you. No conspiracy of enemies will destroy you. Number one, the defilement of the lost. Number two, the decision of a lifetime. Number three now, the deliverance by the Lord. The deliverance by the Lord is coming to you. You will come out through that door. Jesus said, I am the door. I am the way, the truth, and the light. No man comes to the Father but by me. And as you come out of defilement tonight, and you say, I enter in. Welcome. You will enter to the kingdom of God. And then he will forgive all your sins. You say, I've not been like Daniel. Tonight is the starting point. I've not been like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Tonight is the starting point. Your victory is starting tonight. Your deliverance is starting tonight. Your dominion is starting tonight. The deliverance by the Lord.
Remember
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Each
of the fire. And the flame of the fire was so intense and serious. The men who threw them there, they were bunched down and bunched to death.
But
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego,
they
got into the fire. And then they stood up. And they were walking.
What's you wearing?
And then somebody. I said somebody. If you know the Bible, I said somebody. What's his name? Jesus. Everybody shout Jesus. Nebuchadnezzar
said,
let me see the ashes of those people. Enemies will not see your downfall. Enemies will not see your defeat. Enemies will not witness your death. New life is coming to you today. New power is coming to you today. Everything that breaks the yoke is coming in your life. All the fire of Nebuchadnezzar will be neutralized in your life. And he looked inside his furnace. They were not burnt. They were not lying down. They were standing up. And then they were walking majestically. The people that conquered fire. And the people that conquered the fury of Nebuchadnezzar. And the people that conquered in the furnace.
You know,
when you come to the Lord, when you stand in the Lord,
from
today, nothing will conquer your life anymore. Anything they throw at you, there is an invisible wall. Before that thing gets to you, it will strike that wall. That thing will stop right there. Occultism is neutralized tonight. The power of evil is neutralized tonight. And Nebuchadnezzar
said,
did we not cast three people into the fire?
He said,
yes, okay. He said, I see four. He said, 1, 2, 3, 4. I recognize that's Shadrach. I recognize that's Meshach. I recognize that's Abednego. Look at this other one. And the appearance of the fourth one. That's your savior. And the appearance of the fourth one. That's your deliverer. And the appearance of the first one, that's your redeemer. It's like unto the Son of God. It's there tonight. I said it's there tonight. To make up your mind, it will hold your hand. Without him, your life will be a misery. Without him, your life will be filled with suffering. Without him, your life will be oppressed and depressed and destroyed. But with him, he comes from heaven. And there is forgiveness. He comes from heaven. And there is freedom. He comes from heaven. And there is deliverance. He comes from heaven. And there is miracle. He comes from heaven. And there is dominion. Nebuchadnezzar said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the living God, he said, come out. And he came out of the fire. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody there said, praise the Lord. Have you cried? Have you wept? Have you suffered? You're coming out. Those tears will dry up. Those evil things will stop in your life. All the magic will stop in your life. All the powerful continue will stop in your life.
Today,
dominion today, freedom today, a miracle is coming your way. Meshach and Abednego, came out, and the king himself examined them, and everybody examined them. They couldn't see any hurt of the fire. that medical thing you have in your hand.
The
miracle is coming your way today. And then you'll go back to the hospital.
They
will examine you over and over. And
they
will not see any trace of sickness in front of you. I'm talking about what Jesus will do for you. I'm talking about what healing will do for you tonight. I'm talking about what deliverance will come to you tonight. I'm talking about the deliverance we're going to have tonight. And then they came out. You know, out of that, that gave them now promotion. Promotion. The same
Nebuchadnezzar
that said, "Who is that God?" He now turned around. He said, "I've never seen a God like this before, that can deliver like this anywhere." Your enemies will confess. Your enemies will publicize. They are the people to take your testimony. And they tell everybody around. Because the deliverance has come to you tonight. You know,
Daniel?
The king also said, Daniel?
Daniel,
servant of the living God, come out.
Jade.
He came out.
Jade.
And all those lions did not touch him at all. And somebody said,
I don't
know what happened. The lions were not hungry. When Daniel was there,
Daniel,
you know, the lions had just gone for hunting. And they had a lot of animals. They had eaten. They were so full, they couldn't even touch Daniel.
They
were not hungry. And so the king said, if they are not hungry, all those people that conspired against
Daniel,
all the enemies of Daniel, they rounded them up. And they threw them into the lion's den. Were the lions hungry? I said, were the lions hungry? When they see your enemy, they will be hungry. When they see all your detractors, they'll be hungry. You're coming out of that dungeon. No matter how hungry those evil spirits are, they say they want to suck blood. They're looking for blood. And you are passing by. You stand up and square your shoulder. A daughter of the king is passing
by.
And the son of the king is passing on. From today, nobody will suck your blood. No matter how thirsty they are, because the spirit of the conqueror is coming upon your life. And when all those other people that don't have any protection, when they pass on, the people that don't know Jesus, when they pass on, and come and see them, the lions will crush them. That's what
I'm
calling you today. That
will
be a man of decision. And then you'll come to deliverance. The deliverance by the Lord. In that deliverance, there's salvation. They will forgive all your sins. They will set you free from your sins. In that deliverance, there's redemption. They will take your name out of the book of slaves. Those who are slaves of Satan, and slaves of occultism, and slaves of evil power, they will give you redemption. They will bring your name in the book of life. In the deliverance, there is healing. Every sickness in your body, praise the Lord, you are healed tonight. Praise the Lord, you are healed tonight. There's healing in that deliverance. What they call incurable disease, it will be healed out of your life tonight in Jesus' name. In that deliverance, there is a breaking of every yoke and curse. Any curse that came upon you from childhood, Jesus will break it tonight. And they say this is a particular curse, and it's on the community which you came from. And they said, look at everybody joy that came from that place that yoke has been on them. Tonight the Lord will single you out. And the Lord will break that curse away from your life tonight. And that deliverance, that is protection. Protection from the powers of darkness. Praise the Lord, you're free tonight. Then there is preservation. Your life will not be destroyed by any enemy. You will live your full life and your full days on earth. And then promotion has come to you. I said promotion has come to you. And you're going to have it in Jesus' name. But you know, it's for the people that make up their minds. I have decided it. The decision of a lifetime. It's a decision. You turn away from everything that has brought defilement in your life. It's a decision of full repentance.
Lord,
I come. Just as I am, I've been defiled. I've been made dirty. But now I hear that Jesus will wash me. That Jesus will cleanse me. That his blood will take all my sins away. Jesus, I come. I come to him as the Messiah.
And
Daniel tells us he will finish up all your sins.
Daniel is suffering.
He will cancel all the guilt of your sin. Then he will turn you unto righteousness. The door is open tonight.
As you
say, Lord, I come. As you say, Lord, I come. As you say, Lord, I come. A man of decision. A woman of decision. As you stand up.
And
you come through that door of decision. Deliverance will meet you on the way. Salvation will meet you on the way. Dominion will meet you on the way. We can solve all that problem tonight. All the
attack
will be solved tonight. All the yoke can be broken tonight. The peace of God can come to you tonight. Just one step. Just one step.
A
step of decision. Going through the open door. Are you there? I said, are you there? I can't hear much people. I said, are you there? What are you?
You what that?
Raise that hand up.
Now why is talking?
Wave that hand at me. You'll come through the door. Deliverance will come to you. Dominion will come to you. It's bad and eyes closed. This is the moment of decision. This is the moment of entry through that door. The door of deliverance. The door of salvation. And the door of redemption. You are there. And you want this Jesus to become your companion. You want this Jesus to be the one that will be with you in the fire, to be with you in the furnace, to be with you in the flame. I know evil power will be able to conquer you anymore. You want to be converted unto Christ. You want to give your life to Christ. You want all your sins to be forgiven. And you want to be saved. And you want to say, Lord, here I am.
I'm
taking a decision. A decision of a lifetime. Wherever you are, joyfully, happily, courageously, confidently, raise up your hand. Man of decision.